10, Danny Scudero on the sweep. Brought down by 22, Noah Orozco.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for your patience. A few technical difficulties, but we are now live. AMHS Live, as a matter of fact. Foothill College, the scene of tonight's season opener. High school football in the move. The visiting Palma Chieftains. Already trailing 7-0 to the Archbishop Mitty Monarchs. This is JT Hanley for AMHS Live, coming to you from scenic Foothill College. Will Towers with the second down pass. Danny Scudero.
Will Towers pass complete to Danny Scudero.
With a catch and run, Scudero gains about four. That'll bring up third and five.
That's a 3-yard catch and catch to the 38.
Scudero in the slot. Ben Kim split far right. Oh, and a hard count by Wills Towers draws Chieftains offside. And that should move the ball 5 yards forward and moves the sticks as well.
5-yard penalty results in a first and 10.
That's the easiest first down that the Monarchs are likely to see all game. Great crowd here tonight for this opening game. Caden Allard in motion. Towers back to pass. Chase from the pocket. He puts it away. And Wills Towers showing great decision-making on that play, picking up a cool 8 yards.
And they
bring third and two for the Monarchs. And check that, it's a second and three. A.J. Sinizel with the inside handoff from Towers. Rages forward, picks up a 4-yard gain. And the sticks move again. Your Monarchs, led by senior quarterback, number one, Wills Towers. Third year at the helm for the Monarchs. And you can see a lot of maturity in this young man, demonstrating a lot of composure in the first two drives. Towers back to pass. Quick pass. Finds Scudero. And there's a late flag.
Towers pass complete to Scudero. There is a flag at the end of the play. Tackle by Ron Murray.
Referees talking this one over.
A 5-yard face mask called against Palma.
And that'll be a face mask call against Palma. They move the ball to the Chieftain 5-yard line. And that'll make a first and goal for Archbishop Mitty. Head coach Danny Sullivan, also in his third season, prowling the sideline. Inside handoff, that's number six, A.J. And A.J. rumbles forward for it. Monarchs score.
Second
And the Pep Band strikes out for the second time tonight. It'll bring out number 17, Rade Galeb, for the point after attempt. Oh, and a little trickery by the Monarchs. Inside pitch to number 8, Charlie Butler, for the two-point conversion. And with 3:33 on the clock, it's Archbishop Mitty 15, Palma nothing. So that's two possessions and two touchdowns for the Monarchs. Will Towers mixing his play calling up exceedingly well. Inside runs and outside runs, and some excellent passing decisions, including before we were live, first touchdown. Towers finding number 3, Ben Kim, on a long flare pass for the opening touchdown of the game. You can undoubtedly hear the excitement in the crowd as the Monarchs marching down the field in their first two possessions for scores, and then punctuating it with that little trickery for the two-point conversion and the last touchdown. Roddy Gala back again for his third kickoff of the game. He had his first two kicks out of the end zone for a touchback. Let's see if he can make it a hat trick. This one is fielded at the 2-yard line. Oh, and a nice move. Dominic Cadiz with an excellent move, but brought down hard. Chieftains are taking over at their own 39-yard line. Matthew Fuqua back under center. J.C. Escudia, the lone back. There's a flag early on the play. Fuqua tucks it away. And we have a second flag. Let's wait to see what we get. Three flags down on the field right now. The referees will have to conference this. And we may have offsetting penalties. We'll have to wait and see. Fuqua showing good decision-making there.
22-yard gain.
Looked for an open receiver downfield. The Monarchs had everyone covered, so he pulled it down and gained 32 yards on that scamper, but this one is going to come back. Offsetting penalties, and we'll do that one all over again. 3:14 left here in the first quarter. And that's unfortunate for Fuqua. He made some really nice decisions. And after a reconsideration, it looks like the Chieftains have been awarded first down on that unsportsmanlike conduct. Automatic first down. They take over from the 50-yard line. Logan Saldate, 6-foot junior, on that inside slant. Gains about a yard and a half. Second and 9.
Brought down by Zakai Posey.
Palma looking to establish some kind of rhythm here in their second possession of the game. Hand off to Sargente. He's met at the line. Managed to rumble his way for a couple more yards. And that'll bring up third and five. Double tight end for the Warriors. Fuqua completes his pass. And Palma continues to move the sticks. Tidy gain for the Chieftains. Caden Shearer, the receiver on that one. Nice run after catch. That moves the ball down to the Monarch 33. Fuqua operating from the shotgun again. Back to pass. Looking for an inside screen. Oh, and a nifty catch. Logan Saldate managed to catch that in traffic. Get about 3 yards out of that. Second and seven. Inside the last minute here of the first quarter. Fuqua this time under center. Drew Molinari in motion. He's an inside handoff. Monarchs meet Molinari at the line. And he manages to fall forward for just about 2 yards. That should make it third and five. And the clock winding down here inside the first quarter. And before the Chieftains get off a play, we'll on the other end of the field.
And the first quarter of the
after one quarter, it's Archbishop Mitty 15, Palma nothing. We'll be right back on AMHS Live. After that quick break, start of the second quarter, Palma driving, third and five, quick pitch out to number 19, Logan Saldate. Saldate met by Stephen Anaya, but not before he manages to pick up another Chieftain first down. So after a rough start in that first possession, Palma seems to have sorted things out, steadied the ship a bit, and have put together a tidy little drive here on their second possession. down inside the red zone now. Field getting a little bit shorter. Let's see what Palma can come up with. Fuqua under center. Noah Roscoe, the ball carrier there. Gain of about 1 yard. Again, Fuqua lines up under center. Single back in the eye. Hand off to Sargenti. Met at the line, but the second effort by the senior tailback garners about 7 yards, and that'll bring up a third and three on the 14-yard line.
Third down and two for the Chiefs.
So a big test here for Palma on offense and for the Monarchs on defense. Big play early on. Saldate in motion, inside handoff, and nothing doing on that one. The Chieftains trying to use a play action motion to spread out the Monarchs, but they weren't biting on that. Jaden Conover with a tackle. And it's fourth and two. And looks like Palma is going to go for it. Or at the very least, they're going to give the appearance of going for it. Snap, hand it off. Fugue on the keeper, and a big hit. All going to depend on the spot that Fuqua gets. And by less than the length of the ball, the Monarchs take over on downs. Interesting play call by Palma there. Fuqua with the play action and then the keeper. Doe for the stick, but a big hit just before he managed to get to the first down marker. And the ball is turned over to the Monarchs on downs. So an effective drive ends up empty-handed for the Chieftains. Mitty will take over first and 10 on their own 12-yard line. Wills Towers in the backfield, along with Justice Tuapalu. Inside handoff goes to number 10, Danny Scudero. Breaks the tackle and wiggles his way forward. A couple yards. Second down, 7 yards for the Monarchs. Towers stays in the shotgun. Wabaloo, the lone back, back to pass, and a little flare to Wabaloo. Cuts back inside. Makes a couple guys miss, and picks up another first down. So that was a bit of nifty footwork there. Towers, a big, strong quarterback, but surprisingly nimble, and evaded the rush on that. Found Wabaloo. And exhibited a lot of really good touch on that as well. And then left it up to his senior classmate, to add a little bit of individual flair and make his way forward for another first down. Ball now out at the Monarch 28. And from the vantage point up here, looks like a pretty full home side for this opening game. Of course, the Archbishop Mitty Parents Association, AMPA, putting on their annual tailgate cookout. Hot dogs, hamburgers, chicken sandwiches, and all the fixins brought out a big crowd tonight. Timeout here on the field. Head coach Danny Sullivan wants to talk it over. And while they're doing that, bring up a couple of upcoming contests. Women volleyball will be hosting Menlo Atherton on Monday, August 29th, 6 p.m. in the Fiend Gym for their home opener. Monarchs are looking to defend WCAL, CCS, and NorCal Open Division Championships that they won last year, the Triple Crown. Start their pursuit of that at home this coming week on the 29th. Head coach John Wallace and the squad looking ready to defend. Monarchs come back out after the timeout. Back to pass. Towers looks out and finds Scudero. And check that was Charlie Butler, number 8. Nice catch and run. And again, as with their first two drives, coaching staff mixing up the play calling, keeping Palma off balance with a combination of inside runs, outside runs, and some nice pass calls. Delayed handoff up the middle. Tuavalu rumbling forward.
Tuavalu up the middle.
Picks up 6 yards, and that'll be 2nd and 4.
Stop by 54, Von Swin.
Early days here, obviously, but Wills Towers demonstrating a lot of growth and maturity. 3-year starter, as we mentioned earlier. He's mixing his plays up really well and demonstrating a lot of touch. Towers with a really strong arm, but tonight he has demonstrated a lot of touch on his passes. Looks downfield. And he demonstrates that strong arm, finding a diving Danny Scudero. For another Monarch first down. Towers really rifling that ball inside 2 DBs. Scudero running a nice route to split the defensive backs, and Towers finding the seam, moving those sticks. Monarchs now on the Palma 35-yard line. Another 1st and 10. Charlie Butler split left. And Danny Scudero taking the snap from center out of the shotgun. Nothing doing this time, though, as Palma read that. Scudero tackled for 8-yard loss. That'll bring up 2nd and 18. It's the second time tonight, though, that the Monarchs have tried something innovative. Looks like they're not afraid to mix up their play calling. Towers back in the shotgun again, steps up and finds a wide open Ben Kim. Kim has run some nice routes this evening. Managed to shake loose 3 times down the field so far. including that long first catch for a touchdown.
Monarchs get back 10 of those yards.
Archbishop Mitty gaining back 10 yards on that last one. That'll bring up a third and 8 from the Palma 33-yard line. Towers in the shotgun. Guavalu in the backfield. Towers fakes the handoff, and quarterback keeper manages to get about 3 yards, but that's going to be short from what they need. About a 4th and 5. Play comes in from the sideline, and with a 15-point lead here with just under 5 minutes to go till halftime, Coach Sullivan and the coaching staff have decided to try and find those 5 yards. Snap back to Tower. Steps back. Big rush. Manages to evade. And Ben Kim, once again, coming up trumps for Archbishop Mitty. Great comeback route. And Kim climbed high and timed that jump perfectly to pull the ball down right over the top of the defensive back. But again, I have to compliment Will Towers. Will Towers has shown lots of composure. He was under heavy pressure from a weak side blitz. Took a lick at the end of that, but managed to put the ball right where Kim could get after it. And the Monarchs now, 1st and 10 on the Palma 13-yard line. They take a look and decide to talk it over with 4:11 on the clock, a timeout. A touchdown here going into the locker room at halftime would be a nice cushion, obviously, for Archbishop Mitty. And so Danny Sullivan and the rest of the staff, first game of the year, want to make sure that everyone's aware of their responsibilities. Put together a play calling package, undoubtedly. Try and punch in this, what would be the 3rd touchdown of the evening for the Monarchs. The Pit in attendance. Doing their thing right in front of the announce booth here. Pom-poms, as far as the eye can see, having a good time in this opener at Foothill College. And so coming out of the timeout, Justin Tuavalu split just right of Towers. Inside handoff. And Scudero with the pass. Oh, and there's contact in the end zone. Flags coming down everywhere. A.J. Sinizal was absolutely mugged on that by a pair of Chieftain defensive backs. 3 officials all seeing the same thing. And one would expect Pax interference, and that's exactly what we get. So trickery again, 3rd time tonight, with a little creativity. Danny Scudero taking that handoff from Towers, and then attempting to find Sinizal down in the end zone. The next best thing, pass interference, and now the ball rough snap there. Towers managed to pick it up, but not before being tackled for a loss.
Rose, those a sack as well. Back to the 13-yard line.
The ball now spotted on the 13. That'll bring up second and 10. 3:30 left on the clock before halftime. Towers with the play fake. A little flare pass, trying to find Scudero out in the left flat, and just put a little bit too much air under that ball.
Towers pass incomplete, intended for Scudero.
One of the few times tonight that Wills Towers has fired. It'll bring up third and 10. Ball still at the 13-yard line. Play call coming in from the sideline. Justin Guavalu is again split to Towers' right. Big rush. Towers gets the pass off. And looks like it's been picked off. So a bit of defensive play calling there with an inside blitz that wasn't picked up. And Towers had a lot of pressure right in his face, tried to float the ball out to Scudero, but unfortunately, again, a little bit too much air underneath that one. Gave time for Palma to cover up and make that interception in their own end zone, which results in a touchback, and more importantly, a turnover with 3:17 left on the clock. So a long drive there ends with nothing to show for it, and the Chieftains take over at their own 20-yard line. Inside handoff. Number 19, Logan Saldate. Saldate in motion there, and been seeing a lot of that from both sides from Palma this evening.
Saldate on the sweep. Picks up 4 yards.
4 yard gain.
To the 24, second and six.
Clock still running at 2:50 left in the second quarter. Fuqua under center. Saldate again in motion. Play action. Fuqua rolls out right. Looking. Nothing. And great coverage that time by the Monarchs. The senior quarterback showing a lot of patience as he got outside the pocket. But as he checked off his receivers downfield, he found no one open and ultimately had to throw that one away. No gain. 3rd and 6 for Palma.
3rd and 6 for the Chieftains.
And that incompletion does stop the clock. There's a fumble. Ball is still loose. Eventually recovered by the Chieftains. Malachi Marshall with an excellent outside blitz coming from the blind side. Fuqua did not even realize he was under pressure. Fuqua stripping the ball. Really a textbook blitz. And the Monarchs almost coming up with the recovery there, but unable to find a handle on the ball. But there are still 2 minutes and 9 seconds left on the clock. The Monarchs are going to get the ball back here. And based on the first couple of punts earlier in the evening, it's highly likely that they will get another shot at this at the end zone, or at least a field goal attempt. Coming off of this change of possession. First two punts, something less than impressive. Thank you. Owen Sargenti will punt again. Third punt of the night for Palma. And he is well near the back of his own end zone. Slightly low on the snap, but he manages to field it well. A high-hanging kick. And quite a bounce. And Palma has to be happy with the result of that. Charlie Butler was back for the Monarchs. Number eight signaled for a fair catch and then let the ball bounce. Unfortunately for the Monarchs, it took a very generous bounce. Gained about another 12 yards of distance. A 49-yarder that time, thanks to that bounce for Sargenti. The Monarchs take over now with 2:08 left on the clock and no timeouts, having burned through them prior to this possession. So let's see what Danny Sullivan and the offense can come up with here. You'd like to think that if they can get the ball inside of about 35 yards, they would give Roddy Galeb a decent shot at adding three more points to this lead. But they'll need quite a bit of yardage to make that happen. And they're going to get 5 yards of it right here as another hard count draws off Edgar Padilla, number 56, a little over-anxious there for the Chieftains. And that cuts the Monarchs' need for a first down down to 5. It's 2nd and 5. Ball advancing to the Palma 44-yard line. Towers out of the gun. Hard count again. Inside handoff to Senezal. No, a keeper. And Towers, some nifty ball handling there. Towers on the big run. Fooled the Chieftain defense nearly as much as he fooled me. A nice bit of takeaway. Tucked it away and put his head down. And now the ball at the Palma 39. Towers back to pass, takes a look on the sideline, and he has, again, Ben Kim. Kim is working this right side. And in particular, Drew Molinari, the junior free safety. He and Logan Saldate have just been run ragged in this first half by Kim, the senior wide receiver, running some nifty routes and displaying a lot of composure, taking a couple licks, but holding onto the ball and moving the Monarchs down the field. Timeout on the field, and this would have to be Palma having called timeout. Monarchs out of timeouts. Head coach Danny Sullivan talking to his offense right now. And I'm sure reminding them, there's a minute and 38 seconds on the clock. They have plenty of time to move the ball forward. Five more yards would bring it within Galeb's range. 2nd and 1. Towers back to pass. Floats it long. He's got Scudero for the touchdown. And again, you have to compliment these wide receivers. The route discipline that they're exhibiting right now is absolutely fabulous. Scudero ran an inside route, broke it back up the middle, split the two safeties, and then Towers just led him perfectly and let him run onto the ball. An amazing bit of throw and catch Galeb out for the point after conversion. Snap, spot, kick. And it's good. So with a minute 33 left on the clock here in the first half, the Monarchs push their lead out to 22-0. I think the most impressive thing about that last drive is the fact that Archbishop Mitty demonstrated a lot of maturity and patience. They didn't try to force plays. They worked the sidelines well. Kim's reception was really the key to that drive. And again, a lovely mix of interior running, passing out wide, and then the big touchdown pass to Scudero right up the middle. And Palma now looking at a 22-point deficit going into the locker room at halftime. And Danny Sullivan and the coaching staff have to be happy with what they've seen in these first two quarters here at Foothill College. The fans on the home side here are certainly happy with it. Galeb unhappy with that first selection for the kickoff, has asked for another ball. Now he's got the one he wants. Tees it up. First game, just working out all the details. And the senior place kicker steps this one off. With his fourth kickoff of the half. Line drive caught and downed. Will be spotted at about the Palma 18. So obviously the special teams coaching staff electing to squib drive that one. Galeb, as I mentioned earlier in the broadcast, a member of the men's varsity soccer team, and very, very adept onside kicks and driving the ball. Great touch on the ball, distributed it really well there. So 1:31 left on the clock for Matthew Fuqua and the Palma Chieftains to try and get something out of this half. Play fake there, and it fooled no one.
Number 16, Thomas Nunez, in a quarterback sack by 35, Nicholas Sniffman.
And that was actually Thomas Nunez at quarterback. So the backup for the Chieftains now at the helm.
Second and 15.
Not sure if Fuqua was shaken up on that last drive, but Nunez stays in and hands off up the middle. Owen Sargente gains back a good chunk of the yardage lost on that first play of the possession. Bangs forward for about 9 yards. Clock still running, inside 30 seconds now. Third and six. Another inside handoff.
Carries for the first down out to the 28-yard line. First and 10.
JC Escudia rumbling forward there for a first down, but that will amount to nothing, as that will be the final play here of the first half. And an excellent first half it was. The Monarchs gathering up for a quick chat before they head to the locker room. And we're going to take a short break here at halftime. It's Archbishop Mitty, 22, Palma, nothing. We'll be back with more from Foothill College on AMHS Live.
And this will be an 18 total minute halftime, 15 minutes at halftime, and 3 minutes to re-warm up.
Welcome back. It's halftime here at Foothill College. And you know what that means. It's time for the Archbishop Mitty Royals, our award-winning dance team.
First performance of the year.
The best dance team in the Central Coast section. The Archbishop Mitty.
And let's take a listen.
Thank you.
How about that? Your Archbishop Mitty Royals first performance of the year. In the 1970s, those of you that were around to remember some of that music. Great job by the Royals. Quick trip around the league. Looking at some other scores right now. Up in San Francisco at Kezar Stadium, it's the Battle of Sacred Hearts. Sacred Heart Cathedral of the city playing host to Sacred Heart Prep of Atherton. And at halftime, it's the Gators of Sacred Heart Prep leading the Fighting Irish by a score of 9-7 up in San Francisco. Also going on up in the city, the first night game at St. Ignatius. School's history, first night football game. SI taking on Palo Alto in their season opener, and the Wildcats putting on quite a show right now. 34-0 over the Wildcats. So, CL season. Central Catholic. St. Francis, 14-7, 7 minutes left. First half. Many CAL brethren starting their seasons off tonight. Long campaign for all of the schools. A couple of other notes on our athletics. It's water polo. It'll be a presentation of the kickoff tournament this weekend. And next Saturday, they travel to Fondolette. Water polo squad got things underway. Mentioned earlier on, women's volleyball opening up their home season against Menlo Atherton. That's next Monday, August 29th. 6 o'clock start time in the gymnasium. Watch as the volleyball team looking to repeat their three-peat. Defending WCAL, CCS Open.
I am a monarch.
tonight from our West Catholic Athletic League friends and foes. Up in Folsom, they're in the second quarter. It is Sarah 7, Folsom 3. Down in South San Jose, up on Skyway Hill, they're in the second quarter. Wilcox 14, Valley Christian 7. Same score down in Mountain View. Second quarter, Central Catholic 14, St. Francis 7. And up in the city, they're playing Friday Night Lights for a season opener at St. Ignatius, J.G. Murphy Field. And their late second quarter, it is St. Ignatius 41, Palo Alto nothing. Don't forget, next week, your Monarchs will be on the road. Next Friday night, they'll be at Mountain View High School at 7 o'clock kickoff on the road next Friday. Monarchs at Spartans, 7 o'clock next Friday. Then, it is our home Friday Night Lights game on campus, down at Father Wesley Field in Bonnie Stadium, 2 weeks from tonight. Monarchs host St. Teresa on campus. Monarchs and Saints, Friday Night Lights, that's at 7:30, varsity kickoff. 2 weeks from tonight. Don't forget, Archbishop Mitty Volleyball kicks things off on Monday night at 6 o'clock in the field. They will host the Menlo Atherton Bears this Monday night. Be in the field Monday night, 6 o'clock. Volleyball against Menlo Atherton, season debut for your Monday night volleyball team. And now, welcome back to the field where
doubt to have more to cheer for here in the second half. As their team trails 22-0. Coming out of halftime. No one must get carried away. But a 22 lead and a shutout after two quarters has got to be encouraging for the coaching staff as well as the players who've been putting in a lot of time. A tough last couple of seasons for the Monarchs. There's no way of getting around that. The returners coming back into this team with a refreshed attitude. They have a perspective and a new culture this year. Gritty Mitty. Something the players came up with this past December after a disappointing campaign. And the returning players really decided that that's what they wanted to be known for. Their calling card for this season is to be a gritty team competing with the blue-collar work ethic, and certainly so far a lot of that has been on display. And with that blue-collar work ethic has been some innovative play calling and some composure on offense. A handful of trick plays, including a fake point-after kick with an inside pitch leading to a two-point conversion, hence the 22-0 score on the board. So early days, and so far so good for Archbishop Mitty as they head into the second half, hoping to continue what they started in the first half. Big shout out to the Archbishop Mitty Parents Association, AMPA, for putting on their annual tailgate party. Great barbecue by Epicurean Foods. Hamburgers, hot dogs, chicken sandwiches, and all of the trimmings earlier on. A lot of families and alumni mixing and mingling with current students, student athletes. Great community tradition here at Archbishop Mitty to kick off the home football campaign. And after a great meal, these fans have been treated to some excellent first half football. Senior quarterback Willis Towers showing a lot of leadership, mixing up his plays. A couple of good runs on his own and some deft touch, mixing up his passes as well. Dennis Scudero, super double threat athlete as a runner and a receiver. But so far tonight, number 3, Ben Kim, has been the player to watch. With a basket full of clutch receptions, including that first one of the night, which resulted in the first Monarch touchdown. So we're ready to start the second half. Palma to kick off, number 34, Leo Santana. And drives a kick, fielded by Wabalo. Breaks a tackle and brings the ball out. Check that. That was actually Danny Scudero, number 10 on the return. Again, exhibiting that multiple threat. Picking up that squib kick right around his own 10-yard line. Turns the ball out for good starting field position for the Monarchs at their own 40-yard line. Sullivan meets with the team quickly before they break a huddle to head back out. And Towers lining up again in his shotgun position. Inside handoff to Wabalo. And that was faked by Towers. And on the keeper, manages to gain about 7 yards. A late flag coming in behind the play. There is a Palma player down just in front of the Monarchs bench. Initial signal is for an illegal block against Archbishop Mitty. And that will move the ball back 10 yards. They'll replay first down, this time from the Monarchs' own 30-yard line. First and 20. Player down, number 54, Vom Swim. He's back up. Talking to the training staff from Palma, and indicating he has a little problem with his hip. but he's able to get off under his own power. And makes his way over to the sideline so that the trainers can take a closer look. Hopefully it's nothing too serious, and he'll be back after a little bit of treatment. Justice Tuavolo split to the right. Hard count. And again, for the third time tonight, Towers with a great hard count. This time, Edgar Padilla drawn off sides. That's the second time that number 56 has been drawn off. Padilla showing some really good pass rushing early in the first half, but a little too eager. And whether that's something that the coaching staff has caught or not, it's the second time that he has been drawn offside. So the Monarchs gained back 5 of the 10 that they lost. First and 15. Quick count, handoff to Tuavola. Sweeps right and makes his way back to the original line of scrimmage. Will bring up second and 10. So a solid play call, nothing fancy. But after a pair of penalties, one each way, and a play, we're right back where we started. Ball just short of the 40. So second and a long 10. This time, Tuavolo split to the right. Towers from the gun. Motion Scudero. Handoff inside to Scudero. Makes his way to the right sideline, breaks a tackle. And comes up just short of the first down. Scudero on the inside handoff, sweep right. And that'll set up a third and 2. Tuavolo in the backfield again. Charlie Butler in motion, back to pass. And Butler is the target. And depending on the mark here, which he should get, that should be a Monarch first down. Butler, the player in motion, right to left. And then busting that play out into the flat. Towers with a quick look and pass out there to Butler in the flat. Got the yardage they need and about 3 yards more. And it's an Archbishop Mitty first down. Ball snap. Towers back to pass, looking downfield. Checks off the first receiver. Some good pass defending there by Palma. Charlie Butler again, the intended receiver. Brings up a second and 10. Ball is marked at the Palma 46. Scudero again in motion and takes the inside handoff for a sweep, this time to the left. Gains about 5. Freeze with a clock stoppage, apparently an equipment issue with one of the Palma players. When they get that sorted out, they stop the clock with 10:17 left in the third quarter. Looks like that's been sorted out after a substitution. And the Monarchs, second and 8. Towers checks off, looks at the sideline. Signaling coming in from Towers. Oh, and a brush, and it may be a fumble. And it is. And it's recovered. Jose Escutia. And the first gaffe that tonight by the Monarchs. Again, another interior blitz put on by Palma, not picked up. And it could be that the Chieftains have seen something in the pass protection that they want to exploit. That's the second time an interior rush has got Towers. And he lost that one. And Palma takes over after that fumble recovery on the Monarch 43-yard line. And they call a timeout with 10:09 left here in the third quarter. And you can understand at this point why the Palma coaching staff would like to call this timeout. A score here gets them back in the game, potentially changes momentum. And so they want to make sure that everybody's on the same page. First game of the season, a lot of nerves and a little composure is what's needed here by the Chieftains. So they come out after that timeout. Fuqua with the handoff. Escudio falls forward for a couple of yards. Matt Fuqua back in at quarterback for Palma. He was out of the game the final series of the half. May have just been a precautionary move by the coaching staff, but he's back under center now. Another handoff, this time to Sargente. And again, he's met by a whole gang of Monarchs. Malachi Marshall credited with the tackle. Marshall making a return after two injury-plagued seasons. The work that that young man has put in the offseason to get himself back ready to play has been very impressive. Coaching staff, nothing but good things to say about him, and he is definitely one of the featured players to look at. Big blitz by Mitty. Fuqua doing a great job to sidestep that pressure and finding a receiver downfield. Depending on the spot, they may have a first down, and they do. So the senior QB from Salinas, California, evades the pressure to his left and makes a very tough throw. Good for a first down. And the ball now on the Archbishop Mitty 33. Fuqua under center again. Drops back to pass. He's got double wide receivers, split left, and that was nearly picked off. Steven Anaya on the coverage there. And he was the closest to getting anything on that ball. After an incomplete, it's 2nd and 10. To say this is an important possession for Palma might be the understatement of the night. Fuqua with the inside handoff. And that one is sniffed out. And met at the line. Zach Ingposi with the tackle. For no gain, and it's third and 10 for the Chieftains. Triple wide right. A nifty idea there. Logan Saldate breaking back from the wide right position to run an inside route. But unfortunately, Fuqua put under pressure, threw just a little high, and that ball falls incomplete. So that's fourth and 10. This is a big play call. Down 22-0. The coaching staff across the way has decided to roll the dice and go for it with 7:20 left in the third quarter. This time, Fuqua lines up in the shotgun, takes the snap, completes a pass. It's a hook and ladder. And the Monarchs sniff that out. Drew Molinari was the receiver who made the catch. And he managed to get the edge and beat the first tackler. But a whole raft of Monarchs closing that play down for about a 4-yard gain. And more importantly for Archbishop Mitty, a turnover on downs. So a promising drive for Palma ends with nothing. And Wills Towers back at quarterback as the Monarchs take over on their own 29, first and 10. Delayed handoff, Towers pulls the ball back, brings it down, and nothing going. As a matter of fact, he's going to lose a couple on that. Last couple series have been less effective thus far in the second half. Some of the play calling that was working well in the first half. Palma has made a few adjustments, jumping into those gaps and not providing the Monarchs with nearly the opportunity for long gains. Towers broke a couple of those in the first half for significant runs. And on that one, he ended up just getting back to the line of scrimmage. And maybe sensing that, head coach Sullivan calls for a timeout. You can feel a momentum right now, as you do in many of these games, teetering back and forth. A 22-point lead with a little over 6 minutes left in the third quarter. Certainly a comfortable lead, but momentum can shift very quickly in a high school football game. And so Danny Sullivan has decided that discretion is the better part of valor. Called a timeout. Called the team over. And he's going to talk them through this possession. First game of the year, as we mentioned, for both these teams. A lot of preparation has gone into tonight. And that said, the first time you get out there and you're hitting for real, sometimes you need to out, group, calm things down. And that's what the Monarchs have tried to do here. Towers back in the shotgun. Steps back. And a flag whistles that play dead. We may have offsides on Archbishop Mitty. Looked like one of the inside receivers may have started a little early. That's exactly what has happened. Monarchs leaving a little before the snap. They'll lose five on that, and it's now second and 15 at the 24. Tuavalu split to the left. Scudero in motion to the right. Inside handoff to Tuavalu, and he gets back about 4 of those yards. That'll bring up 3rd and about 11. So an interesting play call coming up for the Monarchs here. They obviously want to take care of the ball and try to move the sticks. By the same token, they don't want to do anything silly here and have another turnover this deep in their own territory. Tower steps up, calms the line down, and now he's back in the gun. There's the snap. And again, illegal procedure. This time on Charlie Butler. A little over-eager by number 8. Butler jumping off just a bit. So that'll bring up a 3rd and 16, this time from the 23. And again, the Monarchs need to be smart here. A snap, delayed handoff, pulls the ball back out, and it's a keeper. And he loses about 3 yards. So again, not exactly what we saw in the first half. A smooth running machine for the first 2 quarters is sputtering just a bit. But the Monarchs still with a 22-point lead, under 5 minutes left. And we're going to get our first look at Dylan O'Lean as he gets his first punt of the season. And O'Lean with a high kick. Another favorable bounce. O'Lean doing a nice job there. Heavy pressure, maintained his composure. Nice high hanger and a really good bounce. Very favorable. Got another 13, 14 yards. And push Palma all the way back to start inside their half at their own 43-yard line with 4:27 left to play in the 3rd quarter. O'Lean, a junior. That was literally his first punt of his varsity career. Good start for the young man. Drew Molinari in motion. Inside handoff. Owen Sargenti. Thomas Nunes back at quarterback. Number 16 coming back into the game. That's the second time that he has been under center. Matthew Fuqua out. So Nunes, the backup quarterback for the Chieftains, has assumed the role. Play action. He rolls out to the right. Floats a pass. That one was intended for Logan Saldate. But a little long and a little wide, and that ball incomplete, out of bounds. Will bring up a 3rd and 4 from their own 49-yard line. This will be a big play call for Palma. Working hard to try to get themselves back into this game. Nunes under center, takes a snap, inside handoff. Sargenti pushes forward, but nowhere near a first down. This will bring up a 4th and 4. And with this field position, the coaching staff over at Palma has decided to kick away. Sargenti drops back to punt. And another timeout taken by the Monarchs. .308 on the clock. And some might wonder about the validity of taking a second timeout still in the third quarter. But with a 22-point lead, Coach Sullivan obviously wanting to make sure that his players maintain their composure and their concentration. At this point, it's about him playing intelligent football. The Monarchs would certainly love to put some more points on the board, but what they don't want to do is allow Palma back into the game. So that timeout was just to calm down things. Big booming kick. Charlie Butler. Earns back a few yards off Sargente's punt. Butler, the senior wide receiver and cornerback, also deputizing punt returns, and he gets the ball back out to the 20-yard line. And just when you thought it was safe, a late flag had come in. A holding call pushes the ball back to the 5-yard line. And what was decent field position to start with is now Wills Towers with his toes on his own goal line. He hangs the ball out for Butler, who makes a clean catch and is wrestled down just shy of the 10-yard line. And there is another Palma player down. Gets back up to his feet quickly. That's number 56, Edgar Padilla. Padilla having a good game. We did call his number a couple of times earlier on being offsides. He looks okay and keeps his spot out on the field. Meanwhile, an inside handoff to Butler, sweeping right. And he falls forward for a Monarch first down. So the ball just past the 15-yard line and first down. Plenty of time. Got Scudero. And the ball just a little too far in front of the senior wide receiver. Scudero, an all West Catholic Athletic League returner. Running a nice post pattern there, but unfortunately, Towers passed just a little too far for him. That was a similar route to the one he ran for the third touchdown in the third quarter, or in the second quarter of the game. Unfortunately, this one didn't turn out quite the same. And that'll bring up a second and 10. Justice Tuavolo in the backfield with Towers. Monarchs taking a little bit too much time. That'll be a delay of game and a 5-yard penalty. Moves the ball back to their own 10-yard line. They'll bring up a second and 15. This time Tuavolo lines up deep. Takes the handoff and turns it up. Flag out of the backfield. That's usually a hold. Charlie Butler, the runner. Gained about five. And our officiating crew talking this one over. And after a little conference, so two holding penalties charged to the Monarchs. They bring up third and 15. Check that. Third and 10. Towers back to pass. He finds Butler, but again, just a little bit long. Monarchs will bring on Dylan O'Lean and the punt unit once again. Logan Saldate back for Palma. Good snap. O'Lean this time with a low driving kick, and again he gets a good bounce. And the Monarchs let it roll and down it just across midfield. So two punts for the junior, getting his team out of trouble deep in their own half. Palma taking over with the ball just inside the 50-yard line. Thomas Nunes still at quarterback. He airs one out. And the ball is stripped. Well, you don't see that often. But Austin Barbeau, after being beat by a well-laid pass, managed to strip the ball out and turn what would have been a big Palma gain into a turnover. There is a flag after the play. Monarchs fired up and stepping outside the box, undoubtedly that's going to cost them. And the coaching staff will certainly want to talk to them about their discipline. But you can see on the replay, Barbeau ripping the ball out and just staying with the play, demonstrating a lot of composure and concentration. And that is a huge defensive play for Mitty. A really heady play by Barbeau. And the over-exuberance of the celebration costs the Monarchs some field position. The ball marched back deep in their own half. So they'll take over at the 5-yard line, but I'm sure having the ball will help salve some of the disappointment of that penalty. Interior handoff. AJ Sinizal. Rumbles forward. That's a 12-yard gain. Good enough for a Monarch first down. Number three, Drew Molinari with the saving tackle. If that tackle hadn't been made, we might be talking about another touchdown. As it is, the Monarchs give themselves a little bit of breathing room. Charlie Butler in motion. Another delayed handoff. This one is met well behind the line. That's going to cost Archbishop Mitty about 4 yards. Senezal again, the ball carrier on the play, but that time Palma sniffed it out. And so the clock shows double zeros after the third quarter. That means there's 1 quarter left to play here at Foothill College. And the score remains Archbishop Mitty 22, Palma 0. You're listening to Archbishop Mitty Football on AMHS Live. Welcome back, everybody. There's 12 minutes left on the clock. Monarchs leading 22-0 in this home opener of the 22 season. Will Towers with a delayed quarterback keeper takes it out to the right, rumbles forward. Drew Molinari with a tackle again. Moves the ball out to the 18-yard line. It's now 3rd and 9. Towers out of the shotgun. Low snap, manages to recover. He's got Scudero. And Danny Scudero is heading to the house. And just like that, 3rd and 9 turns into 6 points. The Monarchs with their third long pass touchdown of the evening. That one was special. Danny Scudero again running that interior route, splitting the two safeties. He had to do a little work after the catch to evade that first tackle, and then it was a foot race, which he easily won. Roddy Gelb out for the point after. The kick is up and good. And just like that, with 11 minutes left to play, it's Archbishop Mitty 29, Palma nothing. That has to be a tough, tough momentum moment for the team in white. Palma had been working themselves back into the game and had done a good job of blunting the Monarchs offensively in their first three possessions, forcing 2 punts. But just like that, Wills Towers showing that strong arm, and Danny Scudero showing those fast legs to stretch the lead to 29 points with 11 minutes left in the game. Really brought that pit crowd alive as well. that touchdown right in front of the home stands. And these Monarch students, parents, and alums are being treated to a great opening night of the 2022 varsity football season. Roddy Gallup back out to kick off. And the senior. Short a kick that time. Fielded there by Lucas Milburn. Milburn down at his own 18. And that'll bring the Chieftains back out. And once again, it's the junior, Thomas Nunes, at quarterback, this time starting out of the shotgun. We may have seen the last of Matt Fuqua tonight. And flag before the snap. Looks like a procedure penalty, and that's going to move Palma back 5 yards. Just what they didn't need after giving up that long touchdown. Pass and catch combination, Towers to Scudero. And one would have to think that that's going to be a favorite this year of the Monarchs. As those two linking up for their second score of the evening. First and 15, the ball back at the 13-yard line. Thomas Nunes at quarterback, out of the shotgun. Completes a pass out wide, number 27. It's Gavin Martinez. And Martinez manages to get back the 5 yards they lost on that first procedure. Second and 10. Ball back at the 18 where they started from. Nunes again operating from the shotgun, and you have to suppose they're going to keep it in the air, trying to get themselves back in this game. Nunes completes his pass out wide. A heady play there by the Monarchs to keep that from turning into a first down. That'll bring up a third and 2. Monarchs crowd the box. Palma operating out of the eye. Hand off to the tailback. That's Escudio. And Escudio breaks a couple tackles and busts a big gain. That's his best run of the night. The senior tailback turning up the field. Gain out to his own 45. That's good enough for another first down. So Palma had moments here in the second half where they began to put a few things together. One would have to think at this point they're trying to establish one good drive to build some confidence, not only for tonight, but in the games ahead. There's a little impatience. Monarchs jumping off sides there, gifting 5 yards to the Chieftains. Quarterback back under center. Single back, motion right, inside handoff. Logan Saldate evades the first tackler, but as they've done all night long, the Monarch defensive backs and linebackers have swarmed most of these wide running attempts by Palma. That effort was good for a 3-yard loss, and it brings up 2nd and 8. Operating out of the shotgun, Nunes finds the up receiver. That's number 6, Sargente, again. And he has been the go-to guy on both sides of the ball tonight for Palma. He's played out of the backfield in the slot offensively and has played as an inside linebacker and has done himself no harm in his performance tonight in what right now looks to be a losing effort. But Palma's still moving the ball. The Monarchs putting pressure on. Pass complete to Logan Saldate, the junior wide receiver, with a little inside route. Pass and catch, good for 8 yards, 2nd and 2. Triple wide right this time for Palma. Nunes again from the shotgun. Back to pass, looking downfield, but nothing doing. Zachariah Hernandez applying big pressure. Got that big paw up and swatted the pass down. Nothing makes a defensive lineman happier. And you could see by that reaction. Third and 2. Single back, delayed handoff. Oh, and that's a nifty run. J.C. Escudio squared those shoulder pads, headed up field, broke a couple tackles, and good enough for a first down, down to the Monarch 26-yard line. Escudio again, the lone back with Nunes under center. Double tight end formation. Hand off to Escudio. And that time, sniffed out Zach Angpozi coming up out of the defensive backfield to make the first hit. Stopping Escudio for no gain, bringing up a 2nd and 10. Double split left. Play action. Nunes taking a look. He's got a receiver. That pass was intended for number 20, Caden Shearer. That'll bring up 3rd and 10 with just over 6 minutes left to play. Nunez now out of the shotgun with Escudia in the backfield, flared to his left. Quick interior pass, Drew Molinari. Little curl inside, gains back. About 4 yards, and that'll bring up fourth and a long one. And obviously, the Chieftains will be going for it here. With the clock running, just over 5.5 minutes left to play here at Foothill College. So a decent drive so far by Palma, and the sideline now imploring the fans to get behind the defense. They want to keep this shutout. Chieftains take a look at it, and the coaching staff decides it's time to talk it over. And so with 5:18, they call a timeout. Taking a look at the long view here, obviously a score will do Palma a world of good in terms of working on their confidence. Palma with another WCAL foe coming up next week. They travel to, or host, as Sacred Heart Cathedral will be traveling down to Salinas next Friday night. 7:30 start down there. The Monarchs will be on the road for a 7 o'clock game at Mountain View High School. And what looks like they will be taking a opening night win with them as they head over to Mountain View. Just a few miles from here at Foothill College next Friday night. But back to live action here with 5:18 left. Fourth and one. Handoff. Met at the line of scrimmage. This one's going to be close. That was old-fashioned smash-mouth football. Both lines just trying to get off. Monarchs really crowded the box. And the referees may have to measure this one. But that was force on force. As Escudio banged his way forward. And they are going to measure this one. Difficult to read either team right now. I'm not sure anyone really has a sense of whether this is going to be a first down or not. So a little suspense with 5:12 left on the clock. And while the result may be already out of reach, a little drama here with the measure. And for the second time tonight, the Monarchs turn back the Chieftains on a tough fourth down, a fourth and one call up the gut. And the Monarchs turn that one back, with Palma turning the ball over on downs. And you can see on that replay, literally just inches short. So a tough break for the club from Salinas, who had put together a really nice drive. But for the third time tonight, a well-crafted drive turns out to leave them empty-handed. And the Monarchs take over on their own 16-yard line. Wills Towers hands off to the lone back. Senezal bangs his way forward, gains a couple yards. More importantly, that winds up the clock, and we're inside of 5 minutes left to play in the fourth quarter. Sends on the backfield again. Split left. Low snap. And whistles and flags everywhere. Another illegal procedure. So as you might expect, after a very smooth start, the first two quarters in the opening game, a few more penalties, several offsides and illegal procedures here in the second half, leaving the Monarchs with some things to work on ahead of that game next week at Mountain View. Moves the ball back 5 yards. It's second and 13, and the inside handoff. And J.C. Escudio, or Senezal, pardon me, breaks that run. A great individual effort. He broke two tackles at the line of scrimmage. And gained back a huge chunk of yardage. It's now third and one. Senezal again breaks another tackle, works his way back, and that's going to be good enough for a first down. So the junior running back,
number 16, Elijah Batista, picked up a couple yards on first down.
And check that was Elijah Batista, number 16 on that carry, doing a great job with an individual second effort, and that moves the sticks. Continues to move the clock as we move down to 3 minutes left. Joey Campagna now at quarterback for the Monarchs. A little bit of a high snap there, but he manages to get a handle on it. Interior handoff. Batista rumbling forward. So the Monarchs are going to undoubtedly keep the ball on the ground. Try to grind this one out with 2.5 minutes left and the clock running. Hand off again to Batista, and he rumbles left this time.
2 yard gain.
Gains about 2 yards, and that'll bring up third and two. Campagna looks out wide and gets a call on the play. Delayed handoff. Quarterback keeper. And unfortunately, that one's going nowhere. That one looked like a little bit of a mix-up in the backfield. And again, first game. You're going to expect those kind of things to happen. Campagna brought down. That'll bring up fourth down. And on again for the third time tonight is junior Dylan O'Lean. But not before a timeout. A quick spin around the WCAL. Back up at Kezar Stadium, it's Sacred Heart Cathedral now leading Sacred Heart Prep 13-12 with 4 minutes to go in the game. So the Irish coming back from a halftime deficit. Meanwhile, also up in San Francisco at Murphy Stadium, it's a blowout. Sacred Heart, St. Ignatius now with a 41-0 lead over Palo Alto. Meanwhile, back out on the field. Tricky snap for Dylan Olean, but he booms a high hanger. This one doesn't give him as favorable a bounce as the first two, but a great punt by the junior. Monarchs get downfield and cover that punt. And as the ball is turned over to Palma, there's 1:08 left on the clock. Single back for the Chieftains. Outside pressure. Nunez, he's got a receiver. And Soldate with some nifty footwork. Who works his way forward, but unfortunately, in the process, the junior has gone down and he's grabbing the back of his knee. Trainer's out on the field to take a look at him. Hopefully it's a cramp. Initially, that's what it looks like as he's receiving some treatment. Soldate's had a fine game tonight at wide receiver. Been a dual threat for the Chieftains with some clutch catches and also some great runs. But right now, he's a little worse for the wear with 58 seconds left on the clock. And the training staff from both Archbishop Mitty and Palma looking after Logan Soldate. Again, let's hope that it's nothing too serious. Meanwhile, 9:59 left in the fourth quarter between St. Francis and Central Catholic. And that game is tied at 28-28. With about half of a fourth quarter to go. Soldate looks to be okay. He's moving a little gingerly, but moving off the field on his own. And now that he is safely off, Thomas Nunes at shotgun. Back to pass. And a touchdown. Well, that was a little bit of a late call. Joe Silacci on the catch and score. Silacci stretching for the goal line, and the officials taking a moment to look at that and then deciding that he had broken the plane. And with it, Palma is on the board with 47 seconds left. Gio Gutierrez with the point after attempt, which is good. And the Chieftains, with less than a minute left to play, tally their first touchdown of the 2022 season. In fairness to them, they've been a solid team in the second half of this game. Moved the ball well on several drives. Turned the ball over on downs a couple times. A couple of turnovers, but Palma have shown some potential. They have a young squad, but plenty of talent. And one would have to imagine that there'll be a lot of learning opportunities from this game tonight, including the fact that they were able to break that scoring drought inside the last minute. And they'll be hoping they can take that with them into their next game next Friday night when they open up at home against Sacred Heart Cathedral. So, Gio Gutierrez will kick off for the second time tonight. And there is no onside kick. He kicks away. The ball rolls through the back of the end zone. That'll be a touchback. Monarchs will take over at their own 20-yard line with 47 seconds left in the game. So a solid performance here tonight at Foothill College in the opener. Danny Sullivan and his coaching staff will have a few things to work on moving forward, as one would expect in an opener. But they have to be pleased with the performance of their team. The Monarchs look fit, in shape. And particularly in the first half, were very sharp offensively. They move into victory formation. One more snap should be enough. And the fans sense a W. Long in the making, well worth the wait. And these fans are showing their appreciation for the coaching staff and the players in what has been a very solid opening night performance here at Foothill College by their Monarchs. A good mix of execution on the run, some fine passes and catches from Will Towers to a variety of receivers tonight, Ben Kim among them. And of course, Danny Scudero notching two fine touchdowns tonight. But all in all, a team performance, and one that has netted a victory for the Archbishop Mitty Monarchs in their home opener against the Palma Chieftains. Treating these Monarch supporters to an opening night victory. The final score, Archbishop Mitty 29, Palma 7. So the Monarchs are off next week to Mountain View High School before they return in 2 weeks to wrap up their preseason non-league schedule against Santa Teresa High School. That'll be our next telecast from Foothill College. That's September 9th to join us here when Santa Teresa comes to face your Monarchs. It's 7 o'clock kickoff. We look forward to seeing you here on AMHS Live. For the athletic department, our production crew, and everybody else involved, this is JT Hanley saying good night from Foothill College.
I am a monarch.
Don't you dream me!